When setting up a home network, routers and switches are essential foundational devices. Today, I'll explain the differences between them to help you better understand their roles. First, what is a router? A router serves as a network connector or protocol converter. Its primary function is to connect two different networks, like LAN and WAN, and provide routing between them. The internet itself is essentially built upon countless interconnected routers. Now, what is a switch? Also called switching hubs, they connect multiple endpoint devices within a local area network, computers, printers, servers, etc. They manage data transmission between devices to prevent network congestion. Imagine a traffic officer directing vehicles at an intersection. Switches perform similar coordination, but for data packets instead of cars. Their main difference is that, first, the operation layer is different. Routers operate at the network layer, OSI layer 3, forwarding data based on IP addresses, while switches work at the data link layer, OSI layer 2, exchanging data via MAC addresses. However, three-layer switches are an exception, as they can perform routing forwarding. This doesn't mean they can replace routers, as three-layer switches lack WAN ports, which are typically used for accessing the internet. Second, the application scopes are different. Switches handle internal LAN data forwarding, and routers primarily connect LAN to external networks. In simple terms, with just a switch, you can only play offline games, but to play online games, you need a router for dial-up internet access. In addition, the port count is different. In typical home applications, routers generally provide 4 or 5 ports for networking. If the number of devices you need to connect exceeds the router's port count, we can need a switch. A switch essentially acts as a port multiplier, with most home switches offering up to 24 ports, which can make up for the problem of few router ports. We only need to connect the router and the switch with an Ethernet cable so that we can add additional ports for use. For example, the S13008T switch I have adds 8 extra ports, which you can connect to your computer or printer. I recommend using an unmanaged switch for home use, as it requires no additional configuration and is plug and play, making it very convenient. The above is my summary of the differences between switches and routers. If you want to know more, please see the table below. Even if you're not a tech professional, this video should help clarify their distinct roles. If you found this helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.